MRSA stands for methicillin-resistant Staphylococcus aureus. Staphylococcus aureus is a bacterium that lives on normal healthy people, but the difference with MRSA is that it has acquired resistance to an antibiotic called methicillin. MRSA is an important healthcare problem because patients who come into hospital occasionally get infected with this organism, and if they do so, then that increases their length of hospital stay. It can increase the cost of healthcare and obviously causes harm to the individual patient. People in high intensity settings such as intensive care units are swabbed every week to see if they've acquired MRSA carriage. And if we find two or more people who have, then we suspect an outbreak has occurred. Under those circumstances, the infection control team will go and investigate to see whether they can form links in time between two individuals.
It's a challenge to identify an outbreak because most MRSAs in UK hospitals are from a very, very tightly related group of organisms, a clone, if you like. And MRSAs from various hospitals across the UK, and in fact across the world, will look identical by current typing techniques. So therefore you can't tell if you caught your MRSA from the person next to you or from a visitor, or if you brought it into hospital with you.
In order to be able to tell two bacteria apart, two MRSA strains apart, one would need a much more discriminatory typing technique than we have at the moment.
What we've shown in this work is that newer technologies, which perform the same sequencing process, the whole genome sequencing process, but at a much, much greater speed, can generate the data that we need in a timescale that's relevant to identifying outbreaks.
Our aim was to apply whole genome sequencing to an outbreak investigation on a neonatal intensive care unit to see whether we could group isolates that were associated with the outbreak and exclude those that were not. And we generated this information in just one day.
The experiment we actually did was retrospective. We knew the outbreak had already occurred, but we took these techniques and applied them as if the outbreak was going on in real time. And we found, firstly, what we expected to find, which was that the strains that we thought were part of an outbreak could be shown to be part of an outbreak by this technology, but in a much more rapid timescale. But what we also found, which was unexpected, is that we sequenced a number of control strains, other MRSAs that were around in the hospital at the same time, and we identified a transmission event that had previously been missed purely by seeing that these strains were identical at the genome level.
Whole genome sequencing also allowed us to see all of the genes in the bacterial genome. This allows us to detect antibiotic resistance genes, genes that encode for virulence factors such as toxins. And knowing this could help us change the way we treat patients in the future.
We think that if this technique were in routine use, which we hope it will be in a few years, then we will be able to identify potential outbreaks much earlier and intervene in those outbreaks much earlier, and therefore prevent a lot of downstream problems that currently accrue from outbreaks occurring in hospitals.
The next steps are to develop interpretation tools that interpret whole genome sequence into an output that can be understood by healthcare workers with no specialist knowledge in genomics. The beauty of this technology is that it could be applied to a range of other pathogens that cause infections both in hospitals and in communities. That could allow us to track transmission more accurately, and the benefit that would bring is that we could detect outbreaks more quickly and intervene more rapidly to bring the outbreak to a close.